So we're back in Microsoft Project, and you want to be able to generate a report and put it into, say, PowerPoint. Let's say that you are going to meet with that key stakeholder and you're making a presentation and you want to put it into a PowerPoint or into a deck and you want to add that presentation. You finish putting in your notes. This is on time, ready to go, whatever it is that you're preparing for this particular view, and instead of printing it out in hard copy, you want to put it into, say, PowerPoint. Well, there's a nice feature in Microsoft Project called the Copy Picture feature. And this allows you to quickly and easily get information from Project into another application like PowerPoint or Word, for example. And there's two ways to get at this feature or this function. There's a button here that looks like a little picture of a camera called Copy Picture, and if you don't have that showing, you might have to go to the end of your toolbar, look at the drop-down list, and find it in this area here. I happen to have mine up already, and it looks like a picture of a camera. Now, if you don't want to access it via the toolbar, you can also access it under this Report menu item, which, by the way, is a new menu item to Microsoft Project 2007. So if you're using 2003 or earlier versions, the copy picture will be there, but it'll only be available through the button bar. You won't be able to access it through this Report menu item because it doesn't exist. So if we go back to selecting the copy picture command, I can do that by selecting that icon, or in 2007 I can select Report copy picture, same thing pops up. So what I'm going to do is I've got everything running the way I want it to because I've set up this view to run a specific table and a specific filter in a specific format. So I'm just going to take a picture of this and I'm going to copy it for the screen. And really what that does is that puts it into the clipboard. So I'm going to select OK. Oh, by the way, I can actually say rows on the screen, or I can select rows if I like. So I can do that as well. If I want to do it to the printer, I can. Or if I want to save it as a GIF image file, it will actually allow me to insert that picture, save it for later, and insert it into other applications using the insert picture command, or however you insert images into other applications. So that's another option. For me, a very simple thing to do is save it to the screen and then paste it. It's kind of like copy-pasting, if you will, of whatever view you have running into the application. So I'll just render the image for the screen. We're going to copy the rows on the screen. I could have selected a specific set of rows if I wanted to, but I didn't. You can also control the time scale. So if I like the way it's shown on the screen, I can just keep that, or I can actually adjust that by going from whatever date range you want to select. So I'm just going to select as shown on the screen, and I'm going to hit OK, and that's all you got to do. So now, if I switch to, say, PowerPoint, I'll use my Alt-Tab command to do that. I'll go to a presentation that I have open, which is blank. All I have to do is go Edit, Paste. Just that simple. And in comes the image that I had. So if I have a print preview of that or run that slideshow, that's the exact image that I had running that I used the copy picture to generate from. And now I've got it in PowerPoint. Of course, this is just a vanilla PowerPoint slideshow, but you can put it into whatever slideshow or whatever deck that you have that you need to create. Same thing by putting it into Word. I could just use my Alt-Tab to switch to my Word application. And all I have to do is go Edit, Paste. Now again, it's going to choose, it's going to paste in whatever I have selected. So whatever view I had running, that's what it's going to select and put into my Word document. So if you're creating a project plan in Word and you're, or a presentation, or you're documenting something, you can just take a snapshot of something in Project relatively easy. And I'll go back to my Alt-Tab, and we'll go back to Class Project 1 here. So, for example, if I was running this view, and I selected the Copy Picture command, and for the screen, hit OK. When I went to PowerPoint, and I deleted that out, and I just go, in this case, I'll just go Edit, Paste again. You can also select Control V, and that's a particular view that comes into that presentation. So you can run a specific filter or a table or a view, and whatever you have going on, you can just take a snapshot of that using your copy picture and just easily paste it into PowerPoint, or just as easily paste that into Word or even Excel if I want to. So I can go and delete this one out and just Control V and go edit, paste, and I'll paste that in there so that there is the view that I've created. The lines don't necessarily look good here, but because I'm not close enough, but if I actually zoomed in, all the formatting would come along with it and all the grid lines would be there as well. So the copy picture function in Project is actually one of my favorite tools because I actually have to communicate a lot to different stakeholders, different clients that I work with, and create presentations and create reports in Word. And not everybody has Project and not everybody knows how to use Project yet because they haven't taken this training. And so I use the copy picture command and love it because it allows me to get things into Word and PowerPoint relatively fast. Now, Project 2007 and 2003 also have a wizard to help you do this for you. So if you don't want to actually remember how to go to the copy picture command, there is a toolbar. If I go to view and close to the bottom, there's this item called toolbars. And there's a new toolbar called analysis, new to 2007 and 2003. And I can actually use in this toolbar the copy picture to office wizard. And basically, it'll run you through the questions, the same thing that you would do manually if you went to the copy picture command directly. So you have a copy picture to office wizard that will allow you to get it into PowerPoint or into Word and even Visio for those people who like to use Visio. So that's available to you as well. So take advantage of the copy picture to office wizard if you'd like, or you can simply go and do what I do. I'll just use my Alt tab here to go back to my class one project. Simply do what I do, and that is just use the copy picture button because it's just as easy and you can just decide where you want to put it as opposed to having Project put it in for you. So the copy picture to office wizard's there. I'm going to turn that toolbar off because we're not going to use it anymore and it takes up real estate that I don't want right now. So I'll turn that toolbar off and we're back to where we were. So take advantage of the copy picture button to help better communicate more effectively to your stakeholders, whether you're getting ready for a presentation or you wanted to put something in Word or paste that image anywhere you want. And remember, whatever you have running, what you see is what you get. Whatever view you have or whatever table filter or grouping you have, that's what's going to be taken by the copy picture command. So it's a great tool. Use it, communicate more effectively with it, and you'll be much more successful with Project and on your projects. So let's go have a look at some other formats that we can do by using the Save As command in the next section.